This is an open meeting of Alcoholics Anonymous. We are glad you're all here, especially newcomers. In keeping with our singleness of purpose in our third tradition, which states that the only requirement for AA membership is the desire to stop drinking, we ask that all who participate confine your discussion to their problems with alcohol. This is a closed meeting of Alcoholics Anonymous. In support of AA singleness of purpose, attendance at closed meetings is limited to persons who have a desire to stop drinking. If you think you have a problem with alcohol, you are welcome to attend this meeting. We ask that when discussing our problems, we confine ourselves to those problems as they relate to alcoholism. Open AA meeting. Open meetings are available to anyone interested in Alcoholics Anonymous program of recovery from alcoholism. Non-alcoholics may attend open meetings as observers. Closed AA meeting. Closed meetings are for AA members only or for those who have a drinking problem and have a desire to stop drinking. Now, those two descriptions for the open and closed meeting came directly from AA.org, which is the General Service Office for Alcoholics Anonymous. This headquarters is in New York, and this is directly from Alcoholics Anonymous. Open meetings. Non-alcoholics may attend open meetings as observers, meaning addict came to the meeting and he says, "Hi everybody, I'm so-and-so addict," and then actually starts reading the preamble or how it works or giving comments. That's not appropriate. Observers don't speak or share at an open meeting of Alcoholics Anonymous. They simply observe as visitors.
Open and closed meetings. I will bet you right now, if we went around this room, we would get a lot of different opinions about what an open and closed meeting is. If we took out the blue card and read that, that's also an opinion. That is not conference-approved literature. The AA group pamphlet says clearly, closed meetings are for AA members only, comma, or those who have a drinking problem and, I want to stress end, have a desire to stop drinking. When I run into someone who's willing to tell a newcomer, well, you can go to the closed meeting, just say you have a desire to stop drinking. That's only half of the spiritual requirement found in this conference-approved literature. You don't just get to, that's not like jacks are better in poker. You don't just get to say, that's not your opening hand, I have a desire to stop drinking. Not for a closed meeting. Doesn't mean you need to know you're an alcoholic. But do you have a drinking problem? Open meeting says open meetings are available to anyone interested in the Alcoholics Anonymous program of recovery from alcoholism. Non-alcoholics may attend open meetings as observers. Non-alcoholics may attend open meetings as observers. In other words, open meetings are not all Addictions Anonymous meetings. Open and closed had to do with anonymity. That's where it all started. That if you were a member, you could come to a meeting if it was declared closed, and you would know that the only other people there are other people who were either members of AA or had a drinking problem and a desire to stop drinking. Because your anonymity is yours, and you're entitled to handle it as you want. Open meetings, lots of people could be there. People that don't know they're alcoholic. People that want to listen a little. Family members. Al-Anon members. Professionals. Nurses. Students. Anyone can come to an open meeting. But as an observer. Not as a participant. That's like one of those good words to look up in the dictionary. Observer. It's very clear in every dictionary I look at that participate is not in the definition of observing. Observing, unfortunately, and listen, for new people, the hardest thing to do is to listen, right? Because they hear in so many other places, share about your problems, right? Instead of share your mess with your sponsor and bring the solution to the meeting, because they've heard things other places. So the AA group pamphlet is great for that. And then on page 18, which maybe is the most controversial. But I laugh because how could it be controversial? I know at least two other past delegates or current delegates are in this room besides myself. If you've been to the General Service Conference, the one thing you know is it's not easy to change our literature. It's not easy to create new literature. It's not easy to put your favorite edit in. So when something gets in here, it's pretty significant that AA as a whole has said this is our group conscience. And on page 18, it says the following. The primary purpose of any AA group is to carry the AA message to alcoholics. Experience with alcohol is one thing all AA members have in common. It is misleading to hint or give the impression that AA solves other problems or knows what to do about drug addiction. Now, I'm going to read that one more time. The primary purpose of any AA group is to carry the AA message to alcoholics. Experience with alcohol is one thing all members have in common. It is misleading to hint or give the impression that AA solves other problems or knows what to do about drug addiction. And the long form of tradition 3, first sentence, our membership ought to include all who suffer from alcoholism, period. What I think those two sections mean, which is here where I get branded the liberal, is that if you have alcoholism, you belong here. I don't care what anyone else says. That's what I just read. You belong here. I'm waiting to meet the alcoholic. I always joke around, but maybe I met one today in Prescott, Arizona. Is there anyone here who suffers from alcoholism who has no other problems? Okay. And I don't say that so that we'll just laugh and say that we're all Addictions Anonymous. That's not why I say that. I say that because the first line is very clear. Our membership ought to include all those who suffer from alcoholism, period. Meaning, we don't care what other problems you have. We care about one thing. Are you an alcoholic? Or are you someone with a drinking problem and has a desire to stop drinking? If you are that, welcome. Your other problems are none of our business. Now, Bill writes in other literature, have those other problems seem to be helped by the 12 steps? Absolutely, if you're an alcoholic. If you're an alcoholic and can come into a home group of Alcoholics Anonymous.
Tradition 3, short form. The only requirement for AA membership is a desire to stop drinking. Tradition 3, long form. Our membership ought to include all who suffer from alcoholism. Hence, we may refuse none who wish to recover, nor ought AA membership ever depend upon money or conformity. Any two or three alcoholics gathered together for sobriety may call themselves an AA group, provided that, as a group, they have no other affiliation.